Honestly, I'm trying to stay focused. You must think I've got to be.
What's up, guys? Welcome back. My name is Michelle with Prettiest Problem. And someone asked me in my DMs about makeup brushes. So I'm just going to quickly go over like what brushes I use, how I use them, and hopefully it's helpful to you. So keep watching. So I'm going to just go through as I do my face. I change the order that I do my face all the time. And my brushes are dirty. I did not feel like cleaning them for this video because I just did this. I'm going to show you the brushes that I just used. So the first thing that I usually do is my brows. And in order to shape my brows, I like using a flat concealer brush. So I wanted to show you two different brushes because one is rounded and one is pointed, but both of them are flat brushes and you can pick up your concealer and actually clean up under your brows and give yourself a sharp line. I also clean up on the top of my brows if I made a bit of a mess on the top. So these are definitely staples in my brush collection. The next thing I tend to do is base my eyes. The base basically just helps the shadow to stick, helps the color to show a little better. You can base your eyelid with your fingers, but clearly I have claws and so it gets hard to kind of get into my eyes with my nails. So I like using a brush, and this is like a domed synthetic hair brush. As you can see, it's a rounded brush. It has the synthetic bristles on it and it just helps to pick up the product. Typically I use cream product with this and I just lay the base down on top of my entire lid. Now after I lay my base down, I'm ready for my shadows, and the brush that I have literally the most of in my collection are blending brushes. I have so many different blending brushes. Literally, this is not even like half of the amount of blending brushes. I think anybody who does makeup knows how important it is to have blending brushes. You want to have clean ones on hand. You can have smaller ones that will pack the color on a little bit darker. You have fluffy ones in order to like blend it out and make it nice and blown out, and it just helps the colors to transition. So definitely pick up lots and lots of blending brushes. These are definitely probably used the most out of all of my brushes. The next type of brush that I have plenty of, this is a flat shader brush, and this is what you're going to use to pack on color on your lid. This is a softer bristle brush, but they are tightly packed. So this is used to pack on colors on your lid. Any type of like shimmer color that you're going to put on your lid, or if you just need a lot more product placed down, you're going to use this brush for that purpose. The next type of brush that I have in my collection that I use frequently is a smaller pointed brush. These are pencil brushes. So they just come to a point. This one comes to a point. This one doesn't really come to a point. It's just a smaller detail brush. I use them mostly to put a little highlight on my inner corner, which I absolutely love. It just glams any look up. You can also use them on the bottom of your eye if you're smoking out the bottom of your eye. You don't want to just have pointy ones. You want to have ones that are a little bit more fluffy as well, because sometimes you have to blend out what you put down. So these small detail brushes are really good for that. Also, if you're going to do any like fun details on the top of your eyelid, maybe you're doing a sharp cut crease or something like that, these smaller detail brushes are used for that. The next brush that I would recommend in your collection is to have a flat angled brush. So this brush I actually use for several different reasons, but the most common reason is for eyeliner. So if you're not really good with the product eyeliner that has the brush on it, because it's very easy to mess up with those types of liners, then you want to get yourself a liner brush. Cream is just a lot easier to work with, in my opinion. So if you need a little bit more of a steady hand, then you might want to work on your liners with flat angled brushes. Okay, so that's pretty much the general brushes for the eyes. We're gonna move on to the face brushes. The first brush that I am going to recommend are foundation brushes. And these are actually more of buffing brushes rather than foundation brushes. Foundation brushes are actually flat. I don't really use the foundation brushes for my foundation because I just feel like it leaves streaks, but it's like more of a flat paintbrush kind of. But these I use to apply my foundation. So they're synthetic tip, so it has that white tip at the end. It's good for picking up and placing color, and it also buffs it out really nicely. I love this brush, and this is from Morphe. So it's just very wide and thick, and the bristles are pretty firm, so you can really buff in your foundation. This one is a similar one from Real Techniques, and it's not as dense as this one. I like this as well. I just like the brushes. They won't shear out your makeup as much as like a makeup sponge. Definitely get some wider foundation brushes in your collection. The next brush or two brushes that I love, and this is actually an interesting brush. I don't see this brush commonly, but I picked it up from Japanesque, and it's like a flat angled brush. It's wide like this and it's flat, and I have the smaller version as well, so I have both of these brushes. I use this to work out my concealer, my highlight. I just like the shape of it. Honestly, you're really gonna use any brushes that you feel comfortable using them in that specific area. You just want to make sure you get the right size for whatever area of your face you're working on. This smaller one I use to contour my nose. I just like the way it curves to the curve of my nose, so that's what I use these two for. The next brushes that I love using are these two brushes. So I use both of these brushes for contouring. This one is from Japanesque and it's just a round dome shaped brush, kind of like the foundation brush, but a lot more dense. And I like this to blend out the cream contour because I put it in such a concentrated area, and this just allows that cream to buff out nicely without stretching it too far. And then this one is the angled powder brush, and I like to use this for my powder contour or my bronzer. So I just go over that cream contour to set that bronzer. You can also use this for blush, which I do, and I just pat it on in the blush area. Then I have my powder brush. So I use my powder brush for just that, my powder. So instead of using a beauty blender, I've been using this brush to pack on my setting powder and brush it away. I also use this if my setting powder is too light. I will use this with a skin tone powder just to calm down the brightness on my face. So I love this because it's nice and fluffy and it picks up that powder nicely. It deposits color like really nicely and it's just really soft. I actually got this in a Morphe kit. So one honorable mention brush is a lip brush. So if you have any like cream lip color that is in a palette, or if you're working with clients, you want to get a lip brush. It's kind of like a concealer brush, but it's a really flat, small brush that you can apply the color to the lip. This lip brush is going to be slimmer than a concealer brush that you would use on your brow. I mean, honestly, they're interchangeable, so if it works, you can use it. There's no real rules to it. And last but not least, the final tool. This is not a brush, but this is a beauty sponge. And this I got from Real Techniques. I really like the orange ones from Real Techniques. This will blend out all of your makeup if you choose to use this. This will sometimes sheer out your makeup because it is a sponge, so sometimes it will remove some of the cream product. Not a lot though, just enough to where it blends everything nicely. You do have to fully wet this and squeeze out the water, and it becomes a little bit bigger and a lot more squishy. I just have kind of veered away from the beauty blender a little bit because I just like the way the brushes have been laying my makeup down, but they're interchangeable. These are really good for your concealer as well. If your concealer is like super high coverage and you want to sheer it out, you can always blot it out with this. Also, you can put down your setting powder with this tool as well if the brush is just not working for you. So that is it for all of the brushes and tools that I use. I hope this video was helpful. Again, makeup, there's no real rules. You just kind of do what works for you. And there's so many more brushes and things that I didn't even mention. These are just my main go-to brushes that I use when I'm doing my own face. So I hope this helps. Let me know in the comments what you'd like to see next, and or you can DM me, that's totally fine as well. And I'll catch you guys in my next one. Bye.